Now we are going to discuss Charles Lamb's essay, A Bachelor's Complaint of the Behavior of Married People. Charles Lamb gives various reasons for attacking the married people. This essay does not contain any improbable or unconvincing ideas. Nothing is fanciful here. Really, married people behave in this way only. By pointing out their errors and weaknesses, he wants the married people to correct their behavior. First attack. Charles Lamb says that married people very often display their love for one another in the public. They want to give the impression to the others that they are fond of each other. By displaying their married happiness, they produce a sense of hostility in the mind of the bachelor. The bachelor feels insulted because of their display of exchanging love for one another in the public. The second reason for his attack is the married people very often consider the bachelors as ignorant and incompetent. Just because of getting married, they behave as if they are the brilliant persons. Charles Lamb gives one example, one incident that happened in his life. Once he talked about the most appropriate method for breeding oysters. For that, that married lady mocked at him. It seems that lady thinks Charles Lamb would not have an idea of such matters as he is a bachelor. Third reason for the attack is the married people are very proud of their own children, as if it is the rarest creature in the world. The married people expect the bachelor to show love and affection to their children. But if he showers love and affection to the children, they immediately send their child to the next room. Charles Lamb has the doubt now, whether to show loving attitude towards children or not. He has this doubt. He says that I can love my friend's dog, but not the child, because the dog reminds him of my friend. But the child has a separate existence. Just because it is my friend's child, I cannot love that child. So this is the third reason for attacking the married people. That is, married people excessively proud of their own children. Fourth reason is, after getting married, man becomes indifferent to the bachelor friend. After the marriage, it is the wife who decides whether to maintain the friendship, continue the friendship or not. They do not have any consideration for the duration of friendship before the marriage. So it is the wife who separates the married husband after the marriage. Fifth reason is, women adopt various techniques to put an end to the friendship. Here he gives three methods adopted by the married women in separating the husband from the bachelor friend. First reason is the wife laughing unnecessarily at the words uttered by the bachelor friend. So here the husband finds it strange, and so he doesn't allow the bachelor friend to enter his house. Second method is the wife exaggerates that bachelor friend's behavior or character. So with this reason also, the husband doesn't allow the bachelor friend to continue the friendship. Third technique is the shaking of that base of friendship by telling the husband that you are very innocent, but the friend is very cunning. Because of your innocence only, you have developed a friendship with him like that. She frames some stories to her husband. Sixth reason is the bachelors get degrading treatment from the married women. Charles Lamb gives two incidences that happened in his life. Charles Lamb's married friend invited him for a dinner. Lamb came and waited for so many hours. The wife didn't even give the food to him. She simply said that let her husband come. She should have been considerate enough to serve dinner to Lamb. Second treatment from married ladies is at the time of serving food. Lamb liked the dish of morellas, but the married lady purposefully gave it to her husband, and Lamb was given only the dish of gooseberries, which he didn't like. So these were the reasons for which he is attacking the married people. He was discourteously treated by the married people. If they do not change their behavior, he threatens them, saying that he will disclose their names. The husband and wife can be informal to one another, but when it comes to the friendship, the married women should show some formal politeness to the bachelors, that is, husband's friends.